Caspin Resources is Greg Miles. Greg, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. Good to see you.
Good to have you back. Greg, you've announced here some new conductors identified from airborne EM. Before we talk a bit about them, just taking a step back, remind us about airborne electromagnetic surveys and what they're intended to tell you.
Yeah, good starting point, Andrew. So airborne EM, so we this is done with a helicopter, it flies at low level, close space lines. It has an electromagnetic, well, we generate a current through a coil and it generates an electromagnetic response in the ground. Well, can do if there's something that's sufficiently conductive. And we use these techniques to cover a large amount of ground quite quickly and cheaply. So it's a really good first pass tool for covering, for exploring for massive or semi-massive to massive sulfide bodies. So particularly, nickel-copper sort of bodies that we're looking for. It's not perfect. You can generate false positives, and some people might have noted on our release today that there's a linear kind of feature in the northwest of the area, and that's an example of a false positive. That's a drainage system, so water in the ground conducts, as everyone sort of knows, and so it's not necessarily great for that. In fact, the surface features can mask the bedrock response, but all in all, it's a useful tool, and we did this. This survey was at the back end of last year, and we've only just got the results through now. So it's just another iron in the fire, really.
And how did the results from the survey fit with your plans for XC22, which has been your main focus?
Yeah, so XC22 continues to be the focus. And, we've got an RC rig and a diamond rig working away there at the moment. But I guess what we want to demonstrate is the magnitude of the opportunity at the Yarawindah Brook per se. We think we've got a really large orthomagmatic system there with multiple opportunities. I don't think in exploration, you don't want to put all your eggs in one basket, as they say. So, we've got a number of anomalies that, could be a potential discovery. And we want to kind of build all of these up, to a stage where we can drill test them. So, and I guess what this survey has highlighted to us again is the Brassica prospect.
Well, on that, so what are the plans for XC45 and XC46?
Yeah, so of this survey, there was probably two standout conductors, XC45 and 46, as you said. They're within this broader Brassica prospect area, and it's kind of bit of unfinished business for Caspin at Brassica. We have done some work here in the past, and we've drilled some other conductors a little bit further to the south. They turned out to be sulfide with sort of low level amounts of nickel and copper and a little bit of PGE thrown in there as well. So I guess the positive from that drilling was that it showed that we were in a live magmatic system, but we obviously hadn't hit the sweet spot. Now, not so long ago, we sort of advised the market that we're going to drill a magnetic anomaly, which is described in the announcement today. That's a slightly different feature again. So we already had plans to go back to Brassica and drill test that. And now we've got these other two conductors, XC46, which is sort of available immediately to be drill tested. So, we'll throw that into the mix as well and drill that during the current program.
Good to see you. Greg, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Good on you.